I know you are going to tell me, yes, teacher, I know the colors in English, yellow, blue, red, orange, yes. But the idea is that you are going to use the colors as adjectives, yes, to describe things, yeah. So we are going to study here, for example, first one, you have to recognize the colors that mean yellow, this color, blue, red, orange, green, purple, black, white, gray, pink, brown, light blue, and look at this. If you have this clearly, it's light. For example, if I say light blue, that's mean this one, yes? Light blue. And if I say dark blue, is this one. I can use this to describe, yes, Gabby?
Teacher, I have a question. Sky blue no es celeste.
Yes, and light blue means it's the same.
Okay.
Yes, you can use a sky blue or light blue is the same. Yes. Mm-hmm. As for example, in Spanish, we say naranja, anaranjado, tomate. It's the same color. Yes. So look at this. And now we are going to try to review this. I'm going to give you 2 minutes. Yes, no more, 2 minutes. And you have to think, some things this color, yes, that are at this color. Red, apple. Green, I don't know. Yellow, what? And brown, what? Yes, you have to write 3 examples in each column. Yes, you have 3 minutes to do that right now.
Gold and well, gold is
yes.
Mm-hmm. Sí, yeah. Yeah. T-shirt.
Yeah, it could be. And brown.
Ese sí se me complica un poco.
Yes. Brown, it could be chocolate, as Gabby said. It could be coffee. Yes, it could be trunk, tronco, de una planta, de un árbol. Yes, trunk. And I don't know, another food, it could be beans. Yes. Okay, great. So I'm going to explain you in this case how we are going to use this word. It is for singular. Yes, singular. And we are going to use they for plural. Yes, they for plural. So, on the next part, I'm going to say we are going to add 2 words more here. Yes, because in your worksheet, you can see here. It is this one. It is. Yes. And there means they are. Hay algo importante en inglés que nosotros debemos de saber usar, y es que en inglés, por lo general, a veces menos que sean imperativos, vamos a tener un sujeto en la oración, pero este sujeto no siempre se traduce al español, ¿sí? Así que no intente traducirlo, porque si traduce se va a confundir, ¿ya? ¿Por qué? Por ejemplo, si yo digo, it's a yellow banana. It's a yellow banana, es una banana amarilla. Pero esto de aquí no se traduce como esto es, sino simplemente como es. Es una banana amarilla, ¿ya? Pero si yo quiero decirlo en plural, voy a usar there. Yellow bananas. ¿Sí? Y significaría como que son bananas amarillas. No estas son o estos son o ellos son, sino simplemente como son bananas amarillas. ¿Sí? Es nuestro sujeto para introducir aquí el verbo. Entonces, aquí yo tengo es, que algo es o está, y are, lo mismo, pero en plural. ¿Sí? Que son o que están. En este caso tenemos dos ejemplos aquí. Look at this. It is a green clock. Yes, es un reloj verde. They are, or they're, blue sharpeners. And you have to remember, siempre, 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 el adjetivo, en este caso, los colores que nosotros estamos usando para describir un objeto, van a ir antes del sustantivo. ¿Sí? Siempre van a ir antes del sustantivo. No después, como en español. Sí, es como el ejemplo que yo le decía ayer. No es como la casa roja. Nosotros diríamos the red house. ¿Sí? Primero el adjetivo, primero lo que le describe. And that is what you are going to do here. Yes? For example, it's a red cube. Yes? And the second picture, Gabby, how can I describe this picture?
It's a blue board. No. ¿Cómo era? Backpack.
It's a blue backpack. Yes, it's a blue backpack. Uh-huh. Derek, the next picture. You can use it or there.
No sé cómo se dice eso en inglés.
The color, which color is?
Orange. Orange. White.
Comes. Yes. Gabby, the next picture, please.
Dice, no sé cómo se dice tu chera, no me acuerdo.
You have to review in your vocabulary, Gabby, at the first page.
Chuta, ¿dónde los tendrán mis ojitos? Y se me dice primero y luego lo busco. Please. ¿Dónde están? Pencil case, ya.
Pencil case. Yes.
Ahora sí. Ahora sí, ¿puedo regresar a la oracióncita, por favor?
I'm here.
Yeah. It's light blue, ¿sí? It's yes. A light blue pencil case.
Perfect. Mm-hmm. Okay, Derek. I'm going to wait
it's here. It's a apple green.
No, because we don't have an apple.
They are apple green.
They are green. Green. Where's the color? Green apples, yes? Apples, because we can see here four apples. Gabby?
También digo el color de la computadora.
Yes, uh-huh. We are describing these pictures.
It's a black computer.
Mm-hmm. It's a black computer. Derek, the next one.
It's a brown. Los italianos no sé cómo se dice.
Yes, you have to review the vocabulary. Yes,
sí, perdón, Lisa. No, perdón.
Don't worry. The last one, Gabby.
They're light blue marcadores. No me acuerdo cómo se dice.
They are no markers.
Y que son resaltadores.
Yes.
Uh-huh. ¿Y cómo se dice resaltador?
Highlighter. Yes. So you can see here.
They're a light blue highlighter.
Mm-hmm. Yes, good. Okay, my dears. So you are going to try to describe something around to you. For example, I'm going to say, it's a brown door. It's a black cell phone. It's a light blue case. Yes? Describe three objects around you. And you have to tell me. You have to show me. You can describe your market, your perfume, your desk, your chair, your computer, your pencils, you have a lot of things around you. Yes, Derek, are you ready?
Sí, creo.
Yes, please, but you have to turn on your camera, Derek, because I want to see.
Lisa, estoy un poquito ocupado. Es que también estoy haciendo tareas del colegio.
Okay, but we are going to finish the class in 3 minutes, Derek. Gabby, I start with you.
It's a pink my case. No. It's a another color rosa. It's a pink my perfume.
Yeah.
It's a blue and yellow my glass.
Good. Great, Gabby. Thank you. Derek, try to describe three things around you, please. I can listen, Derek.
It's a blue t-shirt.
Okay.
A brown bed.
Mm-hmm.
A black.
It's, don't forget it.
And it's a black.
Cap.
It's a light blue cell phone.
Okay, very good, Eric. Thank you.